Now, Haworth's structures more correctly represent the cyclic structures of glucose. So, let us draw those Haworth structures. This is the name of the scientist who proposed these structures, Haworth's structures. So, instead of showing the hemiacetal form like that, you can show a proper ring system with oxygen at one of the corners of the ring, right? So, you can show the ring as, we said it is a six-membered pyranose ring. So, let us suppose this is alpha D plus glucopyranose, right? And you have HOHs present here, so you can show them like this. This is the first carbon, and the first carbon if you have H and OH. Second carbon also you have H, OH in this manner. Third carbon, I said we have to be careful while writing, you have to reverse them. So, OH and H. And so, this is the second carbon, this is third, this is the fourth, and this is the fifth, and the sixth one is in the form of a primary alcoholic group. So, this is the sixth carbon of the glucose. So, this is the five-membered pyranose ring, which is resembling our organic compound pyran, right? And here you have HOH. So, this is called as the Haworth structure for alpha D plus glucopyranose. And similarly, how what would be the structure for beta D plus glucopyranose? Let us draw this structure also. Similar structure, they only differ in the configuration of OH at the C1 position. So, only this is going to be reversed and the entire structure will remain as it is. So, you have this six-membered ring, right? And you have these groups attached here and here. Here at C1 position, this is the first, second, third, fourth position, fifth, and sixth is the primary alcohol group, CH2OH. This is the sixth carbon. And here, instead of writing HOH, we will reverse it. We will put OHH. So, and all the other groups would be exactly identical. OHH and HOH. So, this is the beta form of glucose and the alpha form of glucose, which differ in the physical properties, and they are together, they are called as enomers. Enomers are compounds whose structures differ only in the configuration of one particular carbon. That is, the groups attached at one particular carbon are differently oriented. That gives rise to these enomers. So, the two enomers of glucose are the alpha D plus glucopyranose and beta D plus glucopyranose. So, this is about the structure and the structural elucidation of glucose. Now, let us discuss the next monosaccharide commonly found in nature. It is also called as the fruit sugar and it is fructose. And if you observe, the molecular formula of fructose is the same as the molecular formula of glucose. Glucose also is represented by C6H12O6. Fructose also has the same molecular formula, C6H12O6. Then, what is different here? The structure of or the arrangement of the carbon, hydrogen and oxygen atoms in that particular molecule are different. So, let us try to understand the structure of fructose. Just like how the structure of glucose was determined based on the various evidences from the reactions of glucose with different reagents, similarly the structure of fructose was also established, and it was found to be an ketohexose. So, you can say fructose is a ketohexose. What is the meaning of keto hexose? Keto meaning it has a ketonic group present in its molecule, and hexose meaning that there are 6 carbon atoms present in its molecule. As is evident from the molecular formula, we have said it is C6. So there are 6 carbons. Since it is a hexose, this monosaccharide is a hexose, and it contains a ketonic group, that is why it is called as keto hexose. And the following open structure was proposed for fructose based on the chemical reactions, and after studying the chemical reaction, the possible clues were obtained from those chemical reactions, and it was established that fructose can be represented by this open structure. Let us draw the structure, right? So fructose is found to have 2 primary alcohol groups. So what is a primary alcohol group? We saw a primary alcohol group as a sixth carbon present in glucose. Now in the case of fructose, the first carbon as well as the sixth carbon are present as primary alcoholic groups. So first and sixth, there are 6 carbon atoms in fructose, out of which the first is also a primary alcoholic group and the last one is also primary alcoholic group, and the second carbon is found to be present as a ketonic group. So this is the second carbon. If you imagine a carbon over here, this is the second carbon. And third carbon, just like we saw in glucose, the OHHs are reversed compared to the other HOHs. So here the third carbon has OHH attached here. That is the third carbon. Now the fourth carbon has normal arrangement of HOH with OH coming on the right and H on the left. What about the fifth one? Also normal H and OH. So while writing the structure of fructose also, you should be very careful while positioning the OH group on the third carbon. The OH position has to be reversed compared to the other OH groups present in the molecule. So as you can see, how many OH groups are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this also possibly must have given a pentaacetate on acylation. So that is why it is inferred that our the fructose also contains 5 OH groups, and they are arranged in this manner. And the ketonic group is present here. If you compare that with the aldehydic structure, we had an aldehydic group at C1 position, but fructose has a ketonic group at the second position. So this is called as the open structure of fructose. And it is found to be D minus fructose. So fructose is represented as a D minus fructose. Again, what is the meaning of this capital D here? This indicates the relative configuration of the lowest asymmetric carbon in the molecule as compared to the plus glyceraldehyde or minus glyceraldehyde. So the arrangement of HOH on the lowest asymmetric carbon is found to be similar to the arrangement of HOH in plus glyceraldehyde. That is why it is represented as a D configuration. So fructose exists in the D configuration, and this negative sign indicates that a solution of fructose rotates the plane of plane polarized light to the left. So it is levorotatory. We saw glucose was dextrorotatory. We wrote a plus sign. We said it is D plus glucopyranose, right? The glucose. So, and in the case of fructose, it is D minus. The minus sign indicates the direction of the rotation of the plane of plane polarized light is opposite to that observed in the case of glucose. So you represent fructose as a D minus fructose. And just like glucose, fructose also exists in 2 different crystalline forms. So it crystallizes out as 2 different types of crystals with slight difference in their physical properties, just like we saw in the case of glucose. We call them as enomers. right? So similarly, our fructose also has two enomers which differ in the arrangement of the HOH groups on a particular carbon. We will see that shortly. So fructose also, like glucose, exists as two enomeric forms, two different crystalline forms which are called as enomers. Let us see what is the difference in the structures of the alpha fructose and beta fructose. Of course, both of them are levorotatory. They will have the sign negative and the configuration is capital D, or they are similar to the lowest asymmetric carbon, has similar orientation of HOH as plus glyceraldehyde, right? So let us draw the structures of alpha fructose and beta fructose. Just like glucose, the linear structure could not explain all the properties, so they had to come up with a cyclic structure for this also. So you have the hemiacetal structure here also. Let us show those hemiacetal structures and also the ring structures along with the Haworth structures. Just like in glucose, how are the cyclic structures obtained in glucose? We found that the OH group on the fifth carbon got added to the CHO bond that is present in the first carbon, right? Now in this case, that is in the case of fructose, you have the ketonic group present on the second carbon. So let us show the linear structure and then see how to write the cyclic structure, right? So the linear structure we wrote like this for fructose. Third carbon, this is the first carbon, second, on the third carbon you have reversal of OH here, OH comes on the left, fourth one HOH, fifth one HOH, and sixth one is a, again a primary alcohol group. So there are two primary alcoholic groups in fructose, and the ketonic group is present on the second carbon. So how is the cyclic structure of fructose obtained? So before we proceed to the cyclic structure, let me tell you that the linear structure and the cyclic structures of alpha and beta fructose, they all exist in equilibrium with each other. That means all the three forms exist. Only then you can explain all the properties of fructose. So the three structures that we are going to write, this is the open structure of fructose. We will write the alpha fructose and beta fructose with the cyclic structures. So cyclic structures can explain the existence of the enomers, that is the alpha fructose and beta fructose. Now just like in glucose, the fifth, the hydroxyl group that is present on the fifth carbon, this adds to the ketonic group over here and it forms an oxide linkage that gives rise to, in the earlier case we got a six membered ring and we said it is a pyranose ring. Now in the case of glucose, since the OH is adding to the carbonyl group on the second position, this ring would have one carbon less, so it would be a five membered ring with one end occupied with oxygen and the remaining corners with carbon. So four carbons and one oxygen will make up this ring, and that ring is called as a furanose ring because that ring resembles the organic compound furan. What is furan? We will see. So let us show the cyclic structure, how the OH adds over here. So there is C, O, O and H. So what happens when it adds? What is the cyclic structure that you get? Let us write here. So you have C, CH2OH, this one. This one comes here and this becomes the oxide linkage with the fifth carbon, and in between you have CH2OH. This is your fifth carbon and this is the sixth carbon. In between you will have, this is the first carbon, this is second. So you will have a third one and a fourth one, right? What is the third one? We said there is reversal over here for third, so OHH. Fourth one is HOH. So if you number your carbons in these cyclic structures, you are not likely to make mistakes. So you be very careful while writing the HOH in the correct places, because it is important to represent on the right correct side, right? So this is the cyclic structure for alpha D minus, because it is liver rotatory, fructose, and it has a furanose structure. Why did we say it has a furanose structure? Because it is a 5-membered ring, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So it's a 5-membered ring which resembles the organic compound furan. This is furan. So that's why the ring system present in fructose is described as furanose. So you can say it is alpha D minus fructofuranose and beta D minus fructofuranose. So alpha and beta forms. Now let us write the cyclic structure for beta D minus fructose, right? Now it will be exactly similar, the structure will be exactly similar to alpha D minus fructose. Only difference will be the second carbon. At the second carbon, these groups will be interchanged in position. So the CH2OH will come this side and OH comes this side. So they differ only in the configuration of one particular carbon in their structure. So the alpha and beta forms of fructose are also enomers, right? So let us write the structure now. See, you have OH on this side and CH2OH on this side, right? And you have this oxide linkage, right? This is the first carbon, this is the second, third one OH and H, fourth H and OH, fifth one is forming this oxide linkage H. Now let us complete the structure here, CH2OH. So what is this particular structure representing? It represents beta D minus fructose. And as we have said, it has a 5-membered ring with 1 oxygen and 4 carbons forming the ring. And since the ring is similar to the organic compound furan, the structure is said to be a furanose structure. So fructose has a furanose ring system and glucose has a pyranose ring system. Pyranose is related to pyran, the organic compound pyran, whereas furanose is related to the organic compound furan, right? So these two, the beta and the alpha forms of fructose, they are the enomers. That is, they differ in the configuration of only one carbon in their structure. It is a C2 carbon in the case of fructose and it was the C1 carbon in the case of glucose. Now let us write what are called as the Haworth structures. Like we wrote for glucose, we can represent these structures in the form of Haworth structures, which better describe the various groups and their orientations.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.